Let's say we have some parametric equations of this form. X equals x0 plus at, and y equals y0 plus bt for t's between negative infinity and infinity. In this video, we're going to start by trying to figure out the shape graphed by these parametric equations. And now there's two different ways we could go about that. One, we could just start plotting some points on a graph and see what shape we get in that way. Or two, we could try eliminating the parameter t so that we just have a Cartesian equation in terms of x and y, and then see if we recognize the form of that equation. And that's actually the approach we're going to take in this video. So I am going to try to eliminate the parameter here. So if you recall, the way we do that is we start with one of our equations. And in this case, I am going to start with the x equation. And in that equation, we solve for t. Okay, so let's solve for t in this expression. So if we do that, we're going to get t equals x minus x0 over a. And now I'm going to take this expression for t and substitute it into the y equation. Okay, so y equals y0 plus b times this expression for t, x minus x0 over a. Okay, so let's try rearranging this a little bit and see if we can recognize the form. Okay, so I could write this as y equals y0 plus b over a times x minus x0. And I could even rearrange this a little bit further and write this as y minus y0 equals b over a times x minus x0. So do you recognize this form here? What kind of equation does this look like? Well, this is actually point-slope form for a line. So this describes a line with slope b over a passing through the point x0, y0. So then what we've determined is that this original set of parametric equations describes a line with slope b over a passing through the point x0, y0. So let's summarize with a few notes about parametric equation of a line. So here's what we just discovered. The parametric equations x equals x0 plus at and y equals y0 plus bt for t's between negative infinity and infinity trace out a line. And in these equations, x0, y0, a, and b all represent constants, and we want a not equal to 0. So, once again, these equations describe a line, and specifically, it's a line with slope b over a passing through the point x0, y0. So that's the main idea. There are a few other important notes here, though. So, we should note that if a equals 0 and b is not equal to 0, then we have a vertical line. Okay, so how can we understand this? Well, if a equals 0 in our equation up here, then what we're going to get is we're going to get the parametric equations x equals x0 and y equals y0 plus bt. So what's happening here? Well, x equals x0, that's not changing with time, right? There's no t in this x equation. So this is constant with time, which tells us that we're always at the same x value. But you see, y does change with time, right? So that's a vertical line. That's what happens with a vertical line. A constant x value, but different y values. And then one more important note. There are many ways to describe any given line parametrically. So this representation of the line is not unique. And we'll see that shortly in an example.